we're going to make a general Rmax algorithm, and it's going to be really simple because it's going to be an awful lot like the Rmax algorithm we already looked at.
Good.
So I copied over the Rmax algorithm that we had before, and it went like this. We're going to keep track of the MDP, which is to say we're going to have an estimate of the transitions and rewards for all the state action pairs.
Mm-hmm.
Any unknown state action pair, we're going to assume has a reward of Rmax and then a self loop so that we can just get like for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Then we build that MDP, we solve that MDP, and we take an action from the optimal policy with respect to that MDP that we solved. The only difference is going to be this notion of unknown. And the idea is that we're going to have some parameter, call it C, that state action pair is unknown if it's been visited or we've tried it out fewer than C times.
Okay. Is that C different for every state action pair?
That's a good question. So I want to first kind of give the parameterized algorithm. Then what we have to do is, if we're going to say that this algorithm is efficient, we have to derive some value for C and show that it's, not too big and not too small, but,
just right.
Just right, yeah. So the way that we're defining unknown here is that we have some parameter C, and we consider a state action pair SA unknown if it was tried fewer than C times. After that point, then we switch over to the maximum likelihood estimate. So we've tried it C times, and we saw, we went from state S with action A to some state, S53. So if we did that some number of times, if we only did that once, then we're going to estimate a probability of 1 over C for getting that transition. Okay, so this gives us a new estimate of the transitions and rewards based on the data that we've actually gathered.
Okay.
Okay, so I just want to point out that this is the Rmax algorithm we used in the deterministic case, and this very much is related to the Huffington-bound estimate we used in the stochastic non-sequential case, in the Bandit case. We're just grafting the two things together.